Which one of these do you think leads New Zealand in horticultural exports? Well, if you guess kiwi fruit, you'd be right. But wine and apple are also significant produce, coming in at second and third place respectively, followed by onions and potato. Now, this snapshot shows how diverse our horticultural sector is and proves that our country and people are really good at the farming game. A lot of our success we owe to the temperate climate of our nation, which allows these crops to flourish. But for how long will that be the case? Because the consensus in the scientific community is that the global climate is changing, we need to recognize how this will affect our crops in order to prepare, especially because the ones we have today have been bred and conditioned in the current environment. Predicted warmer seasons are especially alarming for half of Aotearoa's crops, whose reproductive phase actually depends on a cold winter. You see, these plants require a certain period of winter chilling before initiating flowering in the following spring. Therefore, the degree of chilling influences the quantity, quality, and timing of flowers, which in turn affect the quality of the fruit. So, how can we prepare our crops for the inevitable, that is global warming, and what would that look like? The way our team approached this was by asking the question, what's stopping our friends from flowering more efficiently? So we went ahead and identified a gene called Centroradialis, or CEN for short. This gene is highly expressed in young plants until the time of natural maturity, when its expression is lowered to allow the plant to flower and hence bear fruit. But this can take up to 5 years for some species. So, using CRISPR technology, we made a cut in this gene to make it non-functional, in hopes of inducing earlier flowering. And the results are quite amazing. Something that used to grow this big for many years before flowering can now be held in this tiny pot. These plants flower constantly, meaning we can harvest this fruit all year round. So not only have we shown it is possible to save years of waiting for the fruit to grow, with the space efficiency of this plant, we can now consider urban farming potential, where environmental conditions such as water, temperature and light can all be artificially controlled for the best produce, thus eliminating any dependence on cold winters. Now, there's still a long way to go for fruit of this sort to be on par with market quality, but at least now we know where the potential ceiling is. By embracing new technologies such as the gene editing we've used, we can equip ourselves with the knowledge and our crops with the right genetics to tackle climate change, so we can preserve New Zealand's status as a premium food supplier. Thank you.